Welcome to Roller Hockey, Mastering the Game. Inline hockey is a fast-growing and exciting sport. This video will demonstrate the basic techniques to improve your overall game. It is important to wear the proper padding and protective equipment. Inline hockey is a fast-paced game, so you're bound to have numerous falls and collisions. Elbow pads and shin guards will save you from scrapes and bruises when you take a spill or a whack from an opposing player's stick. A good pair of hockey gloves is mandatory. They should be flexible and comfortable, but should also provide plenty of padding along the top of your hands. Another important consideration is the type of wheels you use. Companies such as Hyper make different wheels for different surfaces. Your indoor wheels will work best if used only on indoor surfaces. And finally, don't forget a good protective hockey helmet. You should always wear one to help avoid serious injury. Choosing a stick is usually a matter of preference. There are different lies or angles available, and numerous blade curves, so try a few out until you find one that you like. The blade of your stick is made of hard wood and fiberglass. High sticks to an opposing player, even accidental, are a major penalty that can also cause serious injury. Always keep your stick down, even when skating without the puck. When you first learn to skate, stay in control. Learn the basics of skating and stopping before going 100%. To get maximum power and better balance, begin with a good hockey stance. Skates should be shoulder width apart, knees bent, and your back should be straight or only slightly bent. When first starting, throw your body forward. Your first couple of strides should be quick and short until you get up to speed. Notice how our instructor throws himself forward. Also, his body is positioned in front of his skates. Sideways starts are very similar, but cross your outside skate over your front one. Again, those first few strides should be short, but you should lengthen your stride to achieve faster speeds. Once again, the player almost throws himself forward. Then a few short strides to get going, and finally, long strides to achieve faster speeds. When skating, stay in the hockey stance. When pushing off, extend your legs fully. Focus all of your weight on the pushing skate. Push to the sides, not the back like conventional roller skates. Your weight should be on the balls of your feet, not your toes. After fully extending your leg, bring the skate all the way back to the center of your body. Remember, concentrate on keeping your knees bent, focusing all of your weight on the pushing skate, and fully extending your legs. Keep your stick moving in a forward motion along the floor. For maximum speed, hold the stick with one hand only. Your left hand if you shoot right, and your right hand if you shoot left. You can quickly grab your stick with your opposite hand if necessary. Inline hockey requires that all players are comfortable playing offensive and defensive roles. So it's important to be a good backward skater. Most of the same principles we have discussed apply to backward skating. Put your body in the hockey stance. Knees bent, back straight or slightly bent, and weight centered over your skates. Focus all of your weight on the pushing skate and work on getting full extension of your legs. Push to the outside in a circular motion. Bring the skate back to the center of your body. Try not to have too much movement in your upper body. Practice keeping straight. If there is a lot of movement in your upper body, it makes it easy for the opposing player to make a move past you. You're also exerting unnecessary energy. If you practice crossovers until you are comfortable doing them, you can improve your speed when turning. Again, focus your weight on the pushing skate. If you have stoppers on the back of your skates, they probably will get in the way. If you can skate safely without stoppers, we suggest removing them. Push off on your inside edge, bringing your opposite leg over the pushing leg. Notice how our instructor leans towards the inside. His weight is focused on his inside skate. He then follows through, bringing his outside skate over the top. It's a good idea to practice more on your weaker direction. Pivoting, an often overlooked skill, is essential in becoming a top player. Pay attention to our instructor's skates as he pivots frontwards to backwards. He brings his left foot around so that both skates are pointing opposite directions, then follows through with his right foot. If you have an opposing player coming at you, while you're skating backwards, remember these points. First, don't do crossovers once he gets close to you. That makes it easy for him to get around you. Second, try to keep the player to the outside of the goal net. Third, after forcing the player to the outside, pivot forward towards the boards. This action forces the opposing player away from the net where he can't get a good shot. Stopping on inline skates is not an easy feat. Start off slow until you get comfortable. The trick is to lean your body in the opposite direction, then spread your skates apart enough to stay balanced. This takes considerable practice and you're bound to fall, so make sure you're wearing the proper equipment we discussed earlier. What in the world happened to you? During an actual game, you will continually need to react to what's happening around you. This includes dodging fallen players, going full speed into the corner, and quickly changing directions. It's very important that you feel comfortable on your skates. The better balance and agility you have, the better hockey player you are. These drills can help improve these important skills. Practice keeping both skates on the floor. Get used to pushing to the outside. This is a great balance drill. Keep one leg on the floor. Kick the other leg forward, swinging it front to back. Make sure to practice both legs. Next, try jumping on each leg. This will definitely improve your balance. This is the squat drill. As you improve, you can shoot the duck by extending one leg forward. Tug of war with a teammate and balance battle are also great drills that improve your balance and agility. The most exciting players to watch are always the top puck handlers. Good stick handling requires lots of practice and patience. Let's start in our hockey stance. Knees bent, back straight or only slightly bent, and weight centered over your skates. Cup the puck with the blade of your stick. Rotate the stick from forehand to backhand, cradling the puck in each direction. Most of your body movement is in your wrist and hands. Try to bring the puck back and forth, rolling your wrist and hands. Notice how our instructor looks straight ahead and has very little body movement. You don't want stiff arms when stick handling, but the movement should be focused in your hands and wrists. Make as little noise as possible. The less noise, the more you're cushioning the puck, which means better control. Practice increasing your speed. Once you're comfortable doing this, focus on looking straight ahead. Get used to feeling the puck on your stick. When your skills get more advanced, work on using your skates. Practice kicking the puck up to your stick. Now, let's practice skating with the puck. When skating, keep the puck in front of you. Remember, keep your head up so you can see what's going on around you. It's hard to make a good move or pass when you're too busy watching the puck. Now that we have learned some of the fundamentals, let's take a look at some of the drills which will improve these vital skills. Practice pivoting, changing directions every couple of strides. Practice both directions, giving special attention to your weaker side. You can also practice 360-degree turns using the same drill. A great pivot drill is to use a cone. Skate to the cone forward, then pivot backwards, skating back to the corner. Next, pick up a puck and do the same thing. This two-cone drill combines stick handling and pivoting. It takes lots of practice to get this good, but you'll learn valuable skills. A good stick handling drill is the pylon drill. Make sure you keep the puck in front of you and your head up so you can see the cones. Softly cradle the puck with the blade of your stick, bringing the puck from forehand to backhand. Notice how our instructors lean their bodies towards the cones to increase their speed. A variation of this drill is to do 360s around each cone. Remember, hockey is a game of skill that requires practice and patience. Don't get frustrated if you lose the puck when stick handling or fall when skating. Let's practice passing. We'll look at the forward pass, the backhand pass, and the flipper saucer pass. First, the forward pass. The forward pass is usually your first choice for accuracy. Start in the correct hockey stance. Knees bent, back straight or only slightly bent, and weight centered over your skates. Bring the puck back and then forward across the front of your body. Make sure you cup the puck with your stick. Most important, don't slap the puck. Instead, glide the puck, aiming it at your target. The puck should travel from the heel to the tip of your blade, then towards the target. As in stick handling, it's important to keep your head up and eyes on your target. Good passers make it easy for their teammates to receive the puck. Work at being an accurate passer. When you're skating up the floor with your teammate, give him some leeway with the pass so that he can skate into the puck. Don't put the puck behind him or into his skates. When you receive the pass, catch it with your stick. You want to lessen the impact of the puck hitting your stick by slightly cushioning the pass. If you hold your stick too stiff, the puck is likely to bounce off of it, especially on a hard pass. So for better control, practice cushioning the pass by catching the puck with your stick. Sometimes the pass ends up in your skates. Practice using your skates to deflect it. The backhand pass is very similar in motion to the forehand pass. Slightly cup the puck with your stick. Bring the puck across the front of your body in a sweeping motion, aiming the puck at your target. The flip pass is usually used when there is an opponent between you and your teammate. The object is to flip the puck over the opponent's stick and have it land before it gets to your teammate's stick. It's important the puck saucers, like a frisbee, instead of flipping end over end. The movements are similar to the forward pass, but you should follow through higher to elevate the puck. To make it less obvious that you are passing, you can use a rapid flick of your wrist for a quick release. Remember, when skating, it is important that the pass is in front of your teammate. Allow the player to skate into the pass. Passing between two cones is difficult at first, but will improve your timing and accuracy. This drill forces you to keep your head up, otherwise you can run into your own player. Make sure to lead the player when passing.
Let's do it.
Double a three. Sing last line.
Shooting skills can make an important difference on becoming a top goal scorer. Most players tend to put too much emphasis on practicing their slap shot and not enough time on their wrist shot, snap shot, and backhand shot. The wrist shot is by far the most accurate shot. When you approach the net and see holes not covered by the goaltender, the wrist shot is your best choice. Start in your hockey stance. Your bottom hand should slide about halfway down the shaft of your hockey stick. Bring the puck back behind your body, putting weight on your back foot. Next, sweep the puck forward, shifting your weight from your back skate to your front. Cup the puck with the blade of your stick. The puck should start at the back of your blade and travel down the blade and off towards the target. This motion puts a spin on the puck, sending it accurately towards its destination. Follow through, pointing your stick at your target. If you want to aim low, follow through with your stick low. If you want to aim high, follow through high. The power in a wrist shot does not only come from your arms, but from the combination of all these body movements. It's important to work on the transfer of your weight from back to front. Unfortunately, during actual games, you don't always have the luxury of being on your forehand. There will be plenty of good scoring opportunities you will pass up if you don't have a good backhand shot. The backhand shot is very similar to the wrist shot. Cut the puck with your stick and bring the puck behind your body. Follow through, shifting your weight from your back skate to your front. Aim the puck at your target, following through in that direction. Lean your body into the shot to increase your power. Don't rely on your arms for all the power. Instead, put your whole body into it. Notice the movements of our instructor. First, he cradles the puck, bringing it back behind his body, shifting his weight to his back foot. Next, he sweeps the puck forward, shifting his weight to his front skate, and looks up to see his target. The snapshot is probably the single most effective shot. Its quick release and speed make it a very difficult shot for goaltenders to stop. Once you become accurate using it, you'll be regarded as a true sniper. Most of the action for a snapshot is in the wrist and hands. The key is to have a small windup. The snapshot's biggest asset is the element of surprise. Your first step is to look or get a feel to where the puck is on your stick. Next, look at your target. Then take the shot aiming at your target. Notice how our instructor snaps his wrist on the release of the shot. Thank you. The slap shot is by far the fastest shot when it comes to the speed of the puck. It is also the least accurate and should only be used in certain instances. The most common instance is from the point position. Try to keep the shot down, especially if there is traffic in front of the net. A low shot is harder for the goaltender to follow and is more likely to result in deflections and rebounds. To demonstrate the proper technique, we'll start in our hockey stance. Bring the stick up to approximately waist height or higher. Follow through, shifting your weight from your back skate to your front, hitting your stick to the floor right behind the puck. Throw your whole body forward with your stick pointing towards your target. The puck should start at the heel of your stick and travel down the blade and towards the target. The power comes from a combination of body movements, the action of your arms and shoulders, and the transfer of weight from back to front. Follow these steps for a blistering shot. First, our instructor takes a quick look at his target, then raises his stick and takes a quick look at the puck. Finally, he takes a shot, looking back at his target as he follows through. Remember, accuracy is always more important than speed, so practice hitting targets instead of just slapping the puck as hard as possible. Most roller hockey leagues are non-contact, but there are several checks that can be used. We'll show you how. The poke check is a very effective defensive play. The object is to poke the puck off the opponent's stick using your own. If you have an opponent skating towards you while you're skating backwards, keep your stick close to your body. When the opposing player moves close enough, spring your stick forward in a jerking motion. Don't focus your attention on the puck, because if you miss, the player will move past you. Keep your eyes on the player's midsection rather than his head and shoulders. Make sure to stay with the body. Don't grab onto the players, but force the player to the outside using the pivoting skills we learned earlier. Another check is the sweep check. Lay your stick along the floor, sweeping the puck off the opponent's stick. With your stick along the floor, you will cover a lot of area, making it difficult for the opposing player to make a play. The stick lift is also an effective stick check. From behind the opposing player, lift his stick with yours, forcing him to lose the puck. A small movement by your head can get your opposing player moving in the wrong direction. Start to move one direction, then quickly change directions, moving past the player. You can also fake the player using the puck. Draw his attention to the puck, then make a move around him. It's It's also possible to use the boards by banking the puck against them and moving around the player. Dekes are also important when you're one-on-one with the goaltender. Make a move one direction, pulling the goaltender towards you. Then move to the other side, which the goalie has left open. Dekes take time to learn, but with a little practice, you'll leave the goalie caught out of position. This video demonstrates some of the basic skills essential to becoming a better hockey player. With practice and dedication, you will master the game. I